My wife, Sarah, and I are delighted to be with you in Brazil. We have no better friends in the world than the evangelical community. And the evangelical community has no better friend in the world than the state of Israel. None. If you're a Christian in the Middle East, there's only one place where you're safe. There's only one place where the Christian community is growing, thriving, prospering. That's in the state of Israel. Because everywhere else, if you're a Christian, you have to be very careful, or you have to leave. Not in Israel. You are our brothers and our sisters, and we protect the rights of Christians as we protect the rights of all religions. But this isn't only a matter of justice, and it's not only a matter of value. It's a matter of the deepest sympathy in recognizing our common traditions, our common heritage. We know that Christianity grew out of Judaism. From that same tiny land, this barren piece of land at the edge of Asia, that a great story and a great message for all humanity emerged. Now, sometimes people want to hide it, or sometimes they don't want to reveal it. So I want to tell you a story. When I was first elected in 1996, believe it or not, this is my fourth term in office. So I've been around. Now we're going for the Khamsa, we're going for number five. But in my first term, 1996, shortly after I was elected, I invited the then Prime Minister of Turkey to Israel to come and visit Sarah and me with his wife. We had very good relations with Turkey in those days. We had economic relations, defense relations, intelligence relations, everything, and cultural relations, but not that much. Well, we had dinner, and after dinner, I said to my friend, I have a request. You have in the Topkapi Museum in Istanbul this tablet. This tablet was found in the 19th century by an American archaeologist in the tunnel dug by King Hezekiah under Jerusalem. It's written in the Bible. He wanted to secure the water sources of Jerusalem against a Babylonian siege, and or an Assyrian siege, and he built this tunnel. And when the two teams of diggers met, they heard each other's pickaxes, and at the place where they met, they put this tablet, which is about the size that you see it, written in ancient Hebrew, and it says the story from the Bible. Look at what it says. I can't see it. On the day of the tunnel being finished, the stonecutters struck each man towards his counterpart, axe. Axe against axe, and the water flowed from the source to the pool. You know which pool? This is the pool of Siloam, where 700 years later Jesus went in Jerusalem. This tunnel, this tablet, tells a story from the Bible. It's probably the most impressive archaeological find, except for the Dead Sea Scrolls, and it's actually 700 years earlier. So I said, I have a proposal for you, Mr. Prime Minister. We have many, many artifacts, Ottoman period artifacts, because Turkey controlled our land for 400 years, you know. Sometimes I think they forget that they don't control it anymore, but we remind them. And I said, we have so many artifacts in our museum. Choose any artifact you want, and I will give it to you. And he said, I cannot do that. I said, Okay, I have another proposal for you, because I want this tablet from the Bible. I will give you all the artifacts we have in our museums. That's hundreds and hundreds of artifacts. You said, sorry, I cannot do it. I said, you know what? I'll give you $100 million if you give me that stone tablet. He said, I'm sorry, I cannot do it. I said, I have another proposal for you. Choose any price you want. Name any price you want, and I'll meet it. And he said, I'm sorry, I cannot do it. My friend, he said, I cannot do it for a very simple reason. I understand and I sympathize with what you want to do, but we have a large Islamic community in Turkey that has since taken over Turkey. And if I were to give this to you, this would be an admission of a truth that many in my country don't want to admit, that Jerusalem has been your capital for 3,000 years, that Zion is the capital of the people of Israel. Well, you don't need that reminder, do you? You know Israel and Jerusalem are one. And Jerusalem, from the time of King David, 300 years before King Hezekiah, was the capital of our people, has remained the capital of our people, and will remain the united, eternal capital of the Jewish people for all time. You don't need this reminder because you know our history and you know our common roots. And after 700 years after that date, when the stonecutters met each other, there was another great event, the emergence of Christianity. When I met the Pope, Pope John Paul, you want to hear the story? What? Yeah, okay, I'll tell you about it. This was also in my first term in office. I've since met the other popes, but this was the first pope that I met, and he was a great leader. And Sarah and I walked in the corridor in the Vatican. It's a long distance away. And the Pope was standing at the end of the corridor. And when we came close, the first thing he said to us, he looked at Sarah and he said, Polska, Polish girl. I said, not quite, but she looks it. And the second thing he said was, you are our older brothers. You are our older brothers, because the Jewish people and Judaism gave rise to Christianity. In fact, if we hadn't kept the Jewish religion, there would have been no Christian religion. We just celebrated Hanukkah, the Festival of Lights. And you know that the Maccabees, the great leaders of that revolt against the Greeks, rebelled against the ordainments of King Antiochus, who said, you shall not practice your religion. And we battled against it. And the few won against the many. That is an important Jewish holiday, because without it, there would be no Judaism. But that is an important holiday for Christianity, because without it, there would be no Christianity. This is 166 before the Common Era. So Judaism could have disappeared, and Christianity would have disappeared. Our histories are intertwined. Our faith is intertwined. Our values are intertwined. And so every time that we dig with a shovel in our land, we find ancient synagogues or ancient churches, and sometimes we don't even have to dig. There was one day, one summer that was particularly dry in Israel, and in the Sea of Galilee, the water sank down, and in the banks, the mud banks of the Sea of Galilee, we found this, the remnants of an ancient boat, a fishing boat. So we carbon tested the boat, and it turned out to be plus minus 20 years from the time of Jesus. Now, I can't tell you that Jesus was on this boat, but I can't tell you that he wasn't on the boat. It's the same kind of fishing boat that was used at the time. It tells you how deep our histories are intertwined. And when you come to Israel today, you see a country that welcomes you as brothers and sisters. You see a country that values religious freedom. You see a country that believes, is proud of our past, and carries our values to the future. You see a country where the ideal was that every person is born in the image of God. This is the original idea of equality in the ancient world, thousands of years ago. Unbelievable. What a revolution. But these are the values that produced our modern civilization. And they're anchored in the faiths that we hold dear. These are also the faiths, the values that create the future. Israel is seizing the future. We now have an opportunity in Brazil to seize it together. President Bolsonaro says, we are brothers, he said. We are brothers, and we are going to seize the future together. Now, you know that President Bolsonaro's first name is? It's not Jair. That's in Portuguese. It's the original Hebrew name is Yair. Yair is the name of our son, our oldest boy. But Yair means something in Hebrew. What does it mean? It means he who brings light. Light. And I think that we have now an opportunity together to bring a lot of light to the people of Brazil and to the people of Israel. This is an alliance of brothers. Brothers. So I want to invite all of you, as we say in our heritage, and over the years we have said, next year in Jerusalem, I want to invite you on behalf of Sarah and myself to come to Jerusalem, next year in Jerusalem. It's only 2 days away. Please come. We shall welcome you with all the love and warmth that we reserve for family. You are part of our family. And we are part of yours. I look forward to seeing you in Jerusalem, my brothers and my sisters. Thank you. Thank you for coming here. Thank you. I didn't know that people still use stamps, thank you. But I'm very happy.
Ele não sabia. Ele não sabia que usa esses selos aqui, mas eu tenho também outro obrigado que eu quero as duas.
Thank you.